Today we are just doing a quick video of the perfect inferior alveolar nerve block. I'll be just pointing out a few things which I feel have helped me over the years give that perfect block at the right site. This is my friend Dr. John. He works with me, so I won't be giving the injection as such. You'll have to wait for the next video for that injection. But you can just go through all the tips that I mentioned, and let's hope it helps a few. The first thing that you need to do in an inferior alveolar nerve block is feel for the coronoid notch. The coronoid notch is the deepest portion on the anterior border of the ramus. So it's somewhere here in my friend Dr. John, the patient at the moment. So the normal classical inferior alveolar nerve block, you come from the opposite side, and this is the pterygomandibular raphe. So you basically, the lines coming from the center of the thumb going up till the raphe, this is the point of entry. Okay, so when somebody follows this exact technique of the classical inferior alveolar nerve block and still the patient says that he doesn't have any symptom that you expect after a successful inferior alveolar nerve block, that is an indication to the dentist that the mandibular, that the inferior alveolar nerve, it goes, enters the canal at a higher point of the point of entry of the classical nerve block. So in that scenario, follow my tip number 2 and tip number 3. So I would suggest that don't take the point of entry as the midpoint of your, the height of the injection as the midpoint of your finger, but take it as the highest point of the finger, a straight line from the highest point till the pterygomandibular raphe, and the point of entry is lateral to the raphe, somewhere here, coming from the opposite side, bisecting the premolars or near the corner of the mouth. This is the entry point. Second tip I would suggest is this space that is there between the upper maxillary second molar and the mandibular second molar. This space you can bisect in half, and if you have to give a second injection, it should be higher than the midpoint. Again, lateral to the pterygomandibular raphe, coming from the opposite side, somewhere here. So the second tip will be going at a higher point than the first injection always. Last tip is an inferior alveolar nerve block that we have started using. I'm not very sure if it's already been published anywhere, but this is what I use when the first nerve block fails. You palpate the coronoid notch. This is the coronoid notch. You take a point which is about 6 to 10 mm superior to this point and 10 mm posterior, somewhere here. This is your first entry point coming from the opposite side. When you enter at this point, you get premature contact of bone. When that happens, remove your thumb so that the tissues become laxed. Come to the same side, go in 21 to 25 mm. When you go 21 to 25 mm, in a long needle, it's slightly more than half the length of the needle. So when that happens, again, come back to the same side and start feeling for bone. You'll feel bone. So basically what you have achieved is, you have gone in 25 mm length of the needle at a higher level than your coronoid notch, and at a much deeper and better point for penetration. This is my third tip. Thank you for watching. These were my three tips for a successful inferior alveolar nerve block and its alternatives. I hope it helps you. If you have any more questions about the third tip, you can ask me on the comments below. Thank you.